Bach's violin Partita in B minor. Again, from my favorite book of all time, the Voxman Classical Studies for clarinet. And this is the Corrente from that Partita. And a couple things I want to talk about here in particular are air and articulation and how those two are related. And also how air serves to bring out some of the more interesting rhythmic elements of this particular movement. So the first thing I want to talk about is, think of this as one big long tone that is interrupted by your fingers. So think about, I'm just going to play a nice long tone to begin with in the key. I'm just going to play a B. I'm blowing all the way through the instrument. As I'm playing this B, air is coming all the way through the instrument, right? Because I'm holding all of the keys down. I want to think of that air as if I had papers down on the floor, it would be rustling those papers. The air is going all the way through. I'm playing all the way through the instrument. You don't want any of the air to get caught up in your throat, or especially not in your chest. Support from your diaphragm. That diaphragm support should kind of feel like a sit-up. You know, if you were doing a sit-up and sort of were halfway through it, you feel that. That's the muscle that you use to support yourself. So you take a big breath and support the air and blow all the way through the clarinet. Now, I'm going to add some fingers to that. The other thing about playing without articulating is it really does show where my finger technique leaves a little bit to be desired. And also where my voicing isn't going right. I mean, that's why I squeaked there, is because the voicing as I was jumping those registers wasn't correct. So practicing this just with your air before you even start thinking about articulating is really crucial. So think about as though it was a long tone with fingers. Then you add the articulation in, and you don't want to play, this is written with sort of staccato and accents, and you don't want to think sort of that closed off sound, because the air doesn't feel like it's flowing anymore. Hear that again. That's with a stop staccato. So I'm starting and stopping every note. I feel like it doesn't allow the rhythm to flow, certainly, but it doesn't feel like the articulation is appropriate for this. So I'm just going to blow and just sort of use my tongue as a vowel for the air. Right? That's with a really legato tongue. So the air is going and the tongue is just sort of marking time. All right, and then you start to shorten that up a little bit, but never too short that it stops the whole flow of the air through these phrases. Okay, and you can sort of change the width, the length of each of those staccatos to your sort of personal preference. I would not go too short with this, because then it starts to really sound clipped. Second thing I want to talk about is how, the way that the slurs are marked in here, it can either be in sort of 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, or it can some places be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. This is written in 3, 4. But listen to this closely. It does really break itself apart. And if you can bring some of these sort of subtle rhythmic hemiolas and things like that out as you're playing it, it just makes it all the more interesting. So I'll give you an example. The first measure is in 6. The second measure, I'm going to break into 3 plus 3. Then the third measure is in 6. And the fourth measure is 3 plus 3 again. Here we go. So 6-3-6-3. And then it gets really interesting. Really, is if I were to move that over by one eighth note, it would sound like, right? One and one and one and. but it is shifted by one eighth note, which makes it so cool. So, you know, Bach was probably the first jazzer, I have to say. So anyway, bringing these things out, especially in the second section, there's the, some of those 3+3s get offset by a couple of eighth notes as well. Let me see if I can find this. There it is. So, those are the kinds of things you bring out. It becomes so much fun to play. So, I hope this was helpful, and we will see you next week, probably with more Bach. Thanks for watching.